Good morning and welcome to the episode of the Soda Stream News. I'm your host, Naisha Simmons.
And I'm your other host, Carlos Rolon. Today is October 27th and it is a D-Day. And now for weather.
It's kind of cold. But it's alright.
On Wednesday afternoon, the Soda Chess team participated in the first meet of the season right here at School of the Arts. The Soda Silverhawks started the season winning the first match against Gates Chilai and losing the second match to Greece Arcadia. We had the most players ever competing for Soda at the match. Congratulations to the team.
The Soda Halloween contest. Winners from 7th through 10th grade will each get a free ice cream from the next time Colby's comes to Soda. And the winners from 11th through 12th will get a free prom ticket. Nominations can be submitted to Mr. Murphy by email or in room A179.
The next RBTL Masterclass for Fun Home will take place Thursday, November 16th. Paperwork and payment are due by Wednesday, November 1st. So see Ms. Repholz in room N321 or Ms. Cooley in room M416 for more information.
Auditions for Maya Davis and McKenna Cutts' dance concert piece will be in room N320 from 240 to 355. Auditions for Brianna Moorhead and Corinne Harris' dance concert piece will be in N230 from 4 to 515.
Come and experience the thrill of reeling in a catch, as well as taking fun field trips. Any students interested in joining the Soda Fishing Club should stop by the main office in the first floor and see Ms. Underhill for more information to sign up.
Attention all Soda artists. We need you to create a design for Soda's Black Life Matters t-shirt. Entries are due November 9th to the fourth floor house office. Winner gets a free t-shirt and recognition on Soda Stream. See Ms. Weaver in room A432 with any questions.
Attention ladies and gentlemen, in grades 7 through 12, the varsity bowling meeting will be October 30th at 3:30 p.m. and tryouts will be November 6th and November 13th. The buses on both those tryout dates will leave at 3:45 p.m. Please get your recall forms from the nurse.
Students are not allowed to bring any bottle or container of liquid that has been opened or filled into school. Students who bring in their empty water bottles from home can fill them up in either water dispensers located by the band room or by the gym. Students who bring in open containers will have the bottles taken away until dismissal, at which point they will be allowed to pick them up.
Those interested in Ski Club for 2018, if you have not done so already, now is the time to pick up your ski info packet from the third floor house office and bring it home and discuss it with your family. If you decide to join Ski Club, which I hope you do, you need to pay by November 17, 2017, or the prices will go up.
Attention all seniors. Payment for your cap and gown and sash can be made to Mrs. Pierce, who can be found in the first floor counseling office. Payment is $38 and you can pay between now and March 1st.
Also, don't forget that Monday we start our Soda Spirit Week, so please wear pink. And now we leave you with the Theater Technology feature. Have a great day.
Hi, School of the Arts. My name is Mr. Myers. I'm a Theater Technology teacher and I've been at School of the Arts for 17 years. So as ninth graders in theater technology, we like to introduce the majors to what is theater technology and give them a basis or a foundation for the future work that they're going to do. That includes classes like Intro to Drafting, where they will learn paper and pencil drafting of scenery, ground plans, and elevations. We also teach them basic lighting and sound craft, which includes, foundational information about lighting instruments, sound equipment, and their functions and how they work in theatrical productions at a pretty professional level.
I'm looking forward to calling my own show senior year. I'm really excited just to, you know, be a part of all of the shows here, because really everything that I've done right here has been fun, and just another year is just already amazing. So I guess I get to be older while I do it.
My name is Josiah Ritu. I'm a theater tech major and I'm in ninth grade. In future years of tech, I plan to see more direct work on stage, work on lighting and sound. Right now it's more of just sort of getting to know the instruments and work. As we go, I kind of want to see more hands-on. Not that it's not hands-on, it's just more of it as you advance. Theater tech benefits me just because I like being hands-on. I'm a very hands-on person. I don't like sitting in classes and listening all day. So if I can stand up and do things with my physical body, that really kind of helps me learn and develop as a student.
I love the hands-on aspect of being a tech major. I get to take 2 periods out of every day and work with my hands. It's lots of fun.
I also, basically the same thing, but I really just like the interaction and the whole,
doing basically what other people and other majors need to put on a show, all the lighting, all the sets and all that good stuff. I like being a part of that. I like being behind the scenes. Also, I suck at acting, so, hey.
Hi, I'm Ken Canfield, the theater technology teacher here at School of the Arts. I've been here for 13 years teaching at School of the Arts, and I've been teaching in other schools for about 25 years now. We're here in our 10th grade CAD class. This is CAD 1, and right now they're working on a project called CAD Characters. Before this, they've been working on line drawings and simple programming, and from here we're going to start drawing theatrical scenery and doing other technical work. Later on, we're going to be working on Photoshop. And these are all skills that the CAD students, the theater tech students, bring onto the stage later on as they move up into the junior and senior ranks.
Hi, I'm Parker. I'm 12th grade, theater tech major. Theater tech has given me a lot of skills over the years, not just for the building aspects, but it also pays off for a lot of varieties of jobs. But we also learned a lot of things like the CAD program and drafting and there's a whole lot of a medley of skills that we learned that all come together in this lovely major. And even if you don't go into necessarily a computer tech profession in your future, there's a lot of skills in carpentry. Programs you can do, just a whole lot of stuff, and it's just a very beneficial major because it's very well-rounded for any kind of job, and because